New into stock, we have a Ford Mondeo 2-litre TDCi Titanium X. It's a five-door, it's a 2008 on a 58 plate, has done 94,500 miles. The fuel economy is urban, 37.2 miles per gallon. Extra urban, 57.6 miles per gallon, and combined is 47.9. It has a top speed of 130 miles per hour and a 0-60 time of 9.5 seconds. Road tax, 6 months, £107.25. 12 months, £195. And this car is MOT'd until the 13th of December 2018. It's quite a nice car, well equipped, drives pretty good. When I say well equipped, it's got the front and rear parking sensors, we've got alloy wheels, privacy glass, chrome trim. Cavernous boot, the rear seats split in a 60-40 configuration, load cover here. We've got the rear parking sensors at the bottom of the bumper there. I'll just show you in the back. Back seats in the Ford are really comfortable, nice Alcantara center panel finish with this what I assume is imitation leather in the middle and at the sides, the hard wearing bits where you get in and your pants scuff the edges. So that's it looks like brand new in the back here. You've got a rear central armrest, two cup holders, a little place to put your mobile phone or whatever, and I've got my seat quite a long way back, probably further back than most people drive, and there's still plenty of leg room here, and there's also plenty of headroom even when I put my head back. I still don't catch it. Rear electric windows, and you've got privacy glass as well in the back. I'll take you for a drive. Car's got remote central lock-in, but it's got keyless start, so once you've got the key out to let yourself in, it becomes surplus to requirements and it can be anywhere. So the whole keyless start thing seems a little bit pointless to me, but I'd rather have an ignition key. We have a service history here. Nice to see it's in a service book. And on the 5th of August 2007, at 11,288, it was serviced by Ford Direct. So I'm assuming it was a Ford car to start off with. I could be wrong, but that's what it would appear to be. Then, on the 17th of August 2010, at 24,614 miles, it was serviced at People's, I think that's a Ford dealership at Liverpool. And then 30th of August 2011 at 38,502. Then the 22nd of the 2nd 2012 at 48,372. Then there's a little bit of a jump. I'm not sure whether it's been serviced in that time and just the book not stamped, which is a good possibility seeing as it's got a reasonable service history. However, at this moment in time, we can't locate any services between 2012 and 2016. But here again, at 14th of December 2016, serviced at 80,268. So there's probably one missing, really, in the middle there, which we'll try and locate, but I can't promise anything. And then 14th of the 7th, 2018, at 95,521, and that was at ATS Euromaster. So it's got a reasonable service history that you'd expect for a 10-year-old car. The car has done 94,469 miles. So it's only done less than 1,000 miles since it was last serviced. just put that back. It's again good to see you've got the serial number, the key code and so on, all the paperwork. Let's just check that's not, I've not been through this yet, let's just check that's not a service that was missed out. MOT test and it's had two rear springs and they were done on November 2017, and that must have been for the MOT. So it's had money spent on it anyway. It's a good looking car, nice colour combination. I do like the interior, and I really prefer this Alcantara to leather. I think it's more comfortable. It's not as cold in the winter and not as hot in the summer. So you've got the best of both worlds. It looks really, really nice. Contrast stitching on these panels here. You've got aluminium trim on the dash. You've got kind of this dark brushed aluminium inset to the dashboard. And let's just see, where's the, here we go. Height and reach adjustable steering wheel. Really good spec. Quite warm today. Just put the fan on a bit. I've got air con and also heated seats here, front heated seats. And usually you only get two or three positions, but on this Ford you've got five. So I'm assuming that goes from warm to nuclear or something. We've got power folding door mirrors. Again, excellent getting in and out your garage without knocking your door mirror off. And also, if you have to park on the road, it stops other people knocking your door mirror off for you. These cars drive really nice. This is a sub £4,000 car. It drives every bit as good as a BMW stroke Mercedes, I would say, bearing in mind it's 2008, and it's probably a couple of thousand pounds less than you'd pay for at least a couple of thousand pounds less than you'd pay for the equivalent BMW or Mercedes. As I say, it's got just as much comfort. Front central armrest here. We've got Bluetooth hands-free. It doesn't have audio streaming, I will point out. But I'm pretty sure you'll be able to plug it in somewhere, although I can't even see them. Just have a look for them. See if we've got an aux in plug somewhere. No, plenty of cup holders. I can't see an aux in. The front and rear parking sensors, another great accessory that should really be standard on this car, is a heated front screen. They're just unbelievable in the winter. Save you so much messing about. Keep the screen clear and get rid of any ice without you having to get frostbite in your fingers. Plenty of room in the back. Seats fold down. I've not put them down. I can't remember whether they fold completely flat. I would doubt it because most cars don't, but usually a little bit of a lip, but they do fold enough for you to be able to get some bulky pieces of furniture and equipment in. As I always say with Ford's, great gearbox, lovely to drive. nice multifunction steering wheel. Got cruise control on there as well. Great handling. Nice and smooth. So 2008 car, 95,000 miles, and you can't fault the drive. Just test the brakes in a short while and take you up the motorway. But the gear change, clutch nice and light. I've got cameras on both these front windows. I'll try and do this without, yeah, that's working. That one's going to be a bit more difficult. Yeah, that's working as well. So all the electric windows work. Right hand side, or driver's side door mirror works, passenger side works as well. The thing is, the worst thing about one owner cars especially, or one driver cars, is you tend to find that the door mirrors have been set once and never needed to move again unless they've been knocked. So sometimes they seize up and need a little bit of adjustment to get them going again. This is fine. Great driving position. One I assumed would have been going faster, and CD radio, it's just an auxiliary at the moment, and it does give line in, so I'm thinking there must be a plug somewhere for auxiliary in, but I just can't see it. Nice display, rev counter on the left, you've got an information panel in the middle. And then speedo on the right, fuel gauge and coolant temperature gauge, and your, let's just see if I can, there you go, that's actually showing line in there. Onto auxiliary input there, change it to, oops, just concentrate coming on the motorway first. I was indicating, but you didn't want to let me out. So 60 mile an hour there. Cruise control set, there we go, 70 miles an hour. So cruise switch on the right, and you can set on the left here. You can also move your speed up and down with the plus there and the minus, or if you can cancel here with this switch, knock it off completely, or resume on the right here. That's your volume control, and that's showing me how many miles I've got to fill up. That's from the left-hand column, or left-hand switch, sorry, column. There you go, from this switch on the left, you just need to get in front of this chap. He was trying to go faster than me to pull out, now we're trying to go faster than him to pull in. So we got our own little race going there that wasn't benefiting anybody. So phone. Click onto phone. It's got my phone's paired to it at the moment. A redial, phone book, missed calls, etc. And then we can go down to the trip computer. Distance to empty. Instantaneous miles per gallon. Average miles per gallon. Average speed and reset trip. Go back there. Down to settings. Settings. Electronic stability program, information, clock, and setup. Information that shows messages, and that just says cruise control standby. So we've knocked the cruise control off by touching the brake. As I say, for the money, you're not going to get anything that drives any better. They're very economical, I do know that myself. From using them. I always wanted to work for Ford when I was working for Vauxhall. I thought Ford was the way forward, and I was offered the chance to work for them. And I left a very, very good job to go to a Ford main dealer as sales manager. And I started at 8:30. And by 11 o'clock the same morning, I decided I'd had enough. Not very nice people to work for. But you live and learn. The cars were great, the garage not so much. If somebody needs a good, reliable, economical, spacious motorway cruiser stroke workhorse, then you couldn't do any better than playing one of these. Good engine. A very good chassis as well. I'll just turn that down because you may be picking up a whistle on the cameras, and it's actually because it's not tuned into a station there. It's the radio that was whistling. So you've got CD and AUX, so there's no CD. We'll go on to radio.
Been wrongly detained or deported because
I always manage to switch onto news and not music. May or may not be a good thing. a real good gearbox, a real good feel to it. When you're knocking it, you can really, as it comes out of gear, you can really feel it go into neutral, and then you know, as soon as you get past that little bit, it will drag itself in. It's not going to do the gearbox any good by letting it do that, but it will do. Design alloy wheels, tyres are all good. The steering's excellent. I think it could probably do with a little bit of air in the front tyres, which will they'll get checked on the pre-sales checkover. And although that feels pretty cool, that air, it might just benefit from a regas as well. Just whack it up and see. Yeah, that's quite cool. Go back, I'll show you how to delete a mobile from this system, and also pair your mobile too. Nice old Triumph there. Triumph, is it Vitesse? Convertible. When I was younger, I always wanted a Triumph Herald. Things have moved on a bit since then, but I'd still like one now. I thought they were a cracking design. Oh, also, the seat here has got electric seat height adjustment. I know the Orc's Inn is going to be right in front of my face somewhere.